Good morning and welcome again to the 19th episode of our Lenten Devotional. How fast the time flies. We are almost approaching the Passion Week where it will usher us into the Good Friday and then the Easter Sunday, the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So our text today comes from Matthew chapter number 5, verse 17 to verse number 19, which says, "Do not think that I have come to abolish the law or the prophets. I have not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth disappear, not the smallest letter, not the least stroke of a pen will by any means disappear from the law until everything is accomplished. Therefore, anyone who sets aside one of the least of these commandments and teaches others accordingly will be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever practices and teaches these commands will be called great in the kingdom of heaven." I remember when I was in Sunday school, there was once a teacher who was teaching us about the commandments. And how he was teaching us the commandments really didn't reflect on what she really believed in, because she was all through yelling at us, shouting at us. And at times when we got the answers wrong about the commandments, he could insult some of the students, especially those who, according to her view, were seemed to be bullied. In other words, this teacher, what she was doing is what she did not practice what she was teaching about. So in the end of the day, what was left in my impression, even up until today, was her actions and not what she was trying to teach us about. And this is what our passage is telling us today, this morning, that what we do contravenes what we actually believe, then we are teaching contrary people not to obey the laws and the commands of God. In order for us to teach others, we must obey first the commandments and the laws that God has given unto us. And then after we have obeyed it, then comes the very important part of it, that we should live consistent with what we believe, with what we obey. Our lives should reflect just what we believe or what we obey. Because the Bible says, whoever breaks one of this list of these commandments and teaches others to do so is giving a bad example. Yes, you can believe it, but you are not doing what it's saying. You are giving a bad example to other people and you are leading them astray. The judgment is far much more worse. And especially to those people who you have influence over, people who look upon you as a model, if you lead them astray by your example and action, in contrast to what you obey, then you are leading people astray. But also the opposite of this is this, that then you have some people who obey, believe the commandments and the laws of God, and they actually practice it, but comes the most saddest part of it, that they do not teach others to do the same. Yes, they believe, they obey, they live it, but they do not teach others just to live what they are believing in. They are not sharing, they are not witnessing, and they are not passing on the teaching of Jesus Christ. See, that's also another failure on our part. Many of us, where we are, we have really benefited from examples of others. We've got role models whom we've looked up unto. We've got, especially when you're young, you've got your parents, your father, your mother. Perhaps it is your pastor. Perhaps it could even be your teachers. Perhaps it could be relative, neighbors, people who modeled Christianity before you, such that it attracted you to Jesus Christ. And perhaps they also shared that faith that they had in them, so that you are able to come also to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. So this is what I want us to do in this period of Lent. Simply put is this, that yes, we believe in the commandments and the laws of God, and not only that, but secondly, we are practicing it. But this is what I want us to do in Lent. we should share, we should pass it over to other people who are looking unto us as a model, as an example, and those who we have influence over in our lives. This is what the Bible calls us to do, that as we have received, so also we pass it over to the other coming generation. Will you do that in this period of Lent, that you pass, you share about Jesus Christ, even as you obey and practice what he has told you? So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we want to thank you this morning, and even as you progress in this Lent, my prayer is that even as we dig deep in your word, or even as we try our best to practice it, that God will teach others. We will share it with other people so that they may also come into the kingdom of God. May you give us opportunities. May you open up those doors so that God will get an avenue of sharing about this gospel to other people, who are our neighbors, our relatives, our husbands, our wives, our children, and our co-workers about this good news of salvation. So help us by the Holy Spirit. Pray all this trusting and believing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.